Hi there! Welcome back to our series on how to program Synth. I'm João from Sound Particles, and today we'll talk about frequency modulation with the help of our synthesizer SkyDust 3D. To cut a long story short, frequency modulation is a well-known type of synthesis that treats oscillators as operators. These operators are called carriers and modulators. The carriers are the operators that go directly to the output. The modulators are the operators that instead will affect the tone of the carriers by modulating its frequency. You could say that LFOs could do the same thing as these modulators, but here's the difference. LFOs are usually static and below 20 Hz. This means they don't enter the audible spectrum. On the other hand, modulators do enter the audible spectrum and are usually done with ratios. So, if I set a modulator to a 0.5 ratio, it will play half the frequency of the carrier. This guarantees a tonal relationship between carrier and modulator. For instance, if I take the init preset and go to the FM page, I can take off all the oscillators and keep just the first one as a carrier and treat the second as a modulator. Now, if I change the ratio of the second oscillator, it will affect the tone of the first. I will put the ratio of 4, which means the second oscillator will play 4 times the frequency of the first one. And now, changing the modulation gain will determine how much the tone is affected. Now, since I have a ratio of 4, every note I play will be 4 times the frequency of the note. So a series of Cs is always a C. If I change to fixed frequency, in this case, the second oscillator will play on a fixed frequency. So, in this case, I will stop to have the tonal relationship between carrier and modulator. Now, I want to make a key-like sound, and I will begin with the attack. And I want a bright attack to give the impression of the hammer. So I will use the oscillator one with a super short attack, 0 milliseconds, and a short release. And the second oscillator will be the same since it will be its modulator. Now I'm using a ratio of 6 to get a super bright attack. And I also put my octave one octave higher to have double the frequency. And I get something like this. And I think this will work. Now to get the tone of the keys, I will put my third oscillator with being a carrier and the fourth modulating it. And I will have a zero attack with a release of something like 800 milliseconds. And the fourth oscillator with the same. So I will just copy this one and paste it here. And I want a ratio of 3. I think this will work. Now I want the third oscillator, which will be the fifth, modulated by the sixth, and this will get the more mellow sound. So I want to have a ADSR, and I want a decay of 800. Let's solo this one. I want a release too, but I want to have a sustain like this, and I will copy this oscillator to use for the modulator. So now, let's modulate this. Let's get the higher sustain first to get the tone. Something like this, I think, will work. Let's hear them together. Thank you. will also add two more oscillators just to have a chorus vibe. So these last ones will be just a copy of this with no modulation. Just two signs, but with a slight detune between each other. And I think this works. And that's it. I've only touched the surface of what you can do with frequency modulation, but I encourage you all to experiment with that. In the next video, we'll continue to shape the tone of these keys through other SkyDust features. Hope you stay tuned for that. Drop your comments and questions in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe. Have a great one!